Hey there, TikTakers. Today, we will talk about leprosy. Also known as Hansen's disease, it is a chronic infectious disease produced by the bacillus Mycobacterium leprae, which mainly affects the peripheral nerves in the skin, but also to other areas such as the mucous membranes of the upper respiratory tract and the eyes. The main symptoms are skin lesions, which are lighter than skin color, lesions that present decreased sensitivity to touch, heat, or pain, injuries that don't heal in weeks or months, muscular weakness, and in more serious cases, numbness or lack of feeling in the hands, arms, feet, and legs. There are two types of leprosy, tuberculoid and lepromatous. Both produce skin ulcers. However, the lepromatous form is the most serious, with extensive skin lesions, bumps, nodules, and with destruction of tissues, such as nasal cartilage and ears. The leonine phases appears in advanced stages, characterized by multiple nodules on the face and ears, pronounced cheekbones, and dropping tail of the eyebrows. How is it contagious? Contagion occurs between a patient with the possibility of transmitting the disease, because not all of them eliminate bacilli outside their organism, and a healthy person who is susceptible due to their genetic predisposition. Most have natural resistance to Mycobacterium leprae, and even if they enter contact with this bacteria, their immune system is able to fight it off. Transmission occurs by inhaling these small droplets released into the air when someone with leprosy coughs or sneezes. If medication is administered to the patient, after a few months of treatment, he would stop infecting others. Many believe not, but it is a curable disease. The most important thing is to detect it as soon as possible. In 1987, the Venezuelan doctor and researcher Jacinto Combit was awarded the Prince of Asturias Award for discovering a vaccine for its cure. Patients with this disease must be treated by experienced doctors. They will be in charge of administering various medications to the patient for 6 months to 2 years. Early diagnosis and treatment of infected people is essential. In the case of household contact, annual checkups are recommended for at least 5 years after the last contact with a person in the infectious phase, because the symptoms can take up to 8 years to appear in lepromatous leprosy. This disease has been known to affect humanity for at least 4,000 years. During the Middle Ages, it was thought that those who suffered from it were a divine punishment for their sins. They used to expel the sick from the communities and take away all their property. When they were allowed to beg or make a pilgrimage, they had to carry small tablets in their hands, called tablets of San Lázaro, which, when hit in each other, warned people that someone with leprosy was walking nearby. In addition, they also used to carry a small bell with the same function. Although these facts seem very distant to us, leprosy continued to be stigmatized for centuries. Still, in 1909, in Spain, lepers were excluded and their regrouping in leper colonies was ordered as a preventive measure of contagion. Because of these behaviors, leprosy had greater obstacles to early treatment. Although the number of cases continues to decline, there are still quite a few cases in India, being the country with the highest number of infected, Brazil the second, and Myanmar the third. Although from the perspective of public health there is no risk, health personnel must be aware of the appearance of this disease and fight for a mission to expand prevention and treatment and ensure that the limitations of this disease disappear forever. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it. And if you want to see more Draw My Life videos, subscribe to our channel. See you in the next episode!